Now let me talk about the proof of the Fatma rule. Recall that the Fatma rule says that let f be a function defined on an open interval I if f has a local minimum or maximum at c in I and f is differentiable at c, then the derivative of the function f at c is equal to zero. So to prove this theorem, I want to recall a very important fact that if a function f has derivative at c, it means that it is differentiable at c, then the left derivative at c is equal to the right derivative at c, and it is equal to the derivative at this spot. Okay, so let me start the proof. So we only focus on the case where f has a local minimum at c, and then it is similar to proof for the case where f has a local maximum at c. What does it mean by f has a local minimum at c? Then we can find delta greater than zero such that on the interval from c minus delta, c plus delta, the function value at c is smallest. And because I is an open interval, we can really find delta sufficiently small such that the entire interval from c minus delta to c plus delta is a subset of I. Okay, so again, we can choose delta sufficiently small such that f of c is less than or equal to f of x for all x in the open interval from c minus delta to c plus delta, which is a subset of I. Okay, so this, in this figure, I is the open interval from A to B. C is a number in this open interval. And we choose a delta sufficiently small such that this interval is a subset of I and f of c is smallest on this open interval. Okay, now then let's look at the right derivative of the function at c. The right derivative of the function at c is the limit of f of x minus f of c over x minus c as x approaches c from the right side. That means x is greater than c and x is close to c. Okay, so when x is greater than c and x is close to c, we see that f of x minus f of c, f of x minus f of c is greater than or equal to zero. Okay, but x minus c is also greater than zero. Therefore, this quotient is always greater than or equal to zero. As a result, this limit is greater than or equal to zero. So the right derivative of the function f at c is greater than or equal to zero. Okay, now let's focus on the left derivative of the function at c. The left derivative of the function f at c is the limit of the function of the quotient f of x minus f of c over x minus c as x approaches c from the left. That means x is near c and x is less than c. Okay, so x is near c and x is less than c. Okay, so we see that when x is near c and less than c, we still have that f of x minus f of c is greater than or equal to zero. However, in this situation, x minus c is less than zero because we are looking at x less than c. Okay, therefore this quotient is less than or equal to zero. As a result, the limit of f of x minus f of c over x minus c as x approaches c from the left is less than or equal to zero. Okay, therefore the derivative, the left derivative of the function at c is less than or equal to zero. Okay, however, as I mentioned earlier, the derivative of the function f at c is equal to the right derivative of the function at C, and it's also equal to the left derivative of the function at C. The right derivative is greater than or equal to 0, so f prime of C is greater than or equal to 0. The left derivative of the function at C is less than or equal to 0, so f prime of C is less than or equal to 0. Therefore, f prime of C is both greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 0. Therefore, f prime of C is equal to 0. And the proof is complete.